Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 High Grade Zaku 1 Sniper Type, and I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam, link is in the description below. So this is the first release of this kit. There was a unicorn version which I think is exactly the same, aside from color differences. I'm not 100%, but it's a pretty nice Zaku 1. There is modifications like in the chest here, the head, the one knee, the backpack, of course. I think the shoulders are a little different, I think. It's not a whole bunch, really, but it does look good. I really do like it. It's definitely unique compared to the other Zaku 1 high grades I've gotten. And sticker-wise, you got the model eye, and that is it. I did glue the antenna here on the side of the head. It would not stay on. Every time I moved the head, it would fall right off. And the model eye here can come unpegged very easily, but that could be a feature because it means it can go up and down. So you could say it's supposed to do that, even though I don't think it is. But the rest is pretty good. You got the hose here with a wire inside it, which is a little tricky to get together without the hose coming out of the plastic poles. Yeah, there's a lot of seam lines. It is an older kit, so I'll forgive it for that. Yeah, I wasn't expecting it to be as unique looking as it actually is. I didn't really pay much attention to it in the unicorn OVA, but no, it's definitely different compared to the other Zaku 1s. So the head is on a ball joint, and also can hinge forward and back. So it's pretty good. The arms can hinge forward. This one has the shoulder armor, which is on a hinge, so they can still both go out the same amount. And rotate both shoulder. It is a double-jointed elbow, double-jointed wrist. You do have a hinge in the stomach, which I wasn't really expecting. Although I assume the original one had that too, I just forgot. Waist rotation is fine because there's no hosing. You got the front skirts that can move separately. You got the hinge side skirts, which don't go out a super amount. So legs can go forward, a little back, as far out as the ball joint will allow. You've got a double jointed knee, but the bottom joint really just does that. And then these are the older style Zaku feet, which are actually really good. Because they can come out, they have a flip-flop action. But then they have a hinge in here, and then they have, like, you can go forward and back, and also tilt. But then you've got the joint, the ball joint in here, in the polycap, which is on a hinge. So you've got a lot of articulation. You can bring it, well, not quite what I want to do, but you can bring it out and have it like really far tilted. If the hips were better at going out, it would be really good in the leg department, but the ankles are much better than the hips allow to show off. So, I mean, articulation is nothing amazing, but it is a sniper, so you don't really expect too much in terms of that, but it's still pretty good. So we've got a few different hands. You got a pair of holding hands, which it doesn't have anything to hold, like no melee weapon. Although it does have two different open hands. You have the one that it originally came with, which would do the job for the sniper rifle, but then you have one specifically made more flat. And you do have the machine gun you can use if you want. It has a sticker there for the sensor, movable extra handle, nowhere to peg it in. But it can work with a holding hand, which I have on the sniper rifle right now. It's a little wobbly, there's no tab to hold it, but it'll do the job. It does have another two stickers for the sensors. This one here does move. There we go. Yeah, it does move. Looks pretty good. It has this peg here. I don't know what it's for, because on the pictures, it doesn't show anywhere it pegs onto, and I don't see any ports. But once you get it into the hand, you take this piece here that is tabbed onto the backpack, and then you tab it onto a hole on the sniper rifle. So now it's getting power directly from the backpack, which is a nice looking backpack, I have to say. And then this is kind of conformed to the shape of the shoulder a little bit. And then you can utilize this specific open hand And you do have this unique knee pad, which is made to come down so that it can kneel and be supported by that. Yeah, I don't find it super necessary, but it does look good. It does its job. It looks pretty decent with that down. Very simple, a couple joints, but it's effective. And those are the accessories. Not a whole bunch. It doesn't need a whole bunch. It's a sniper. So, I like the fact that he gave us a specific hand to hold it, even though the one it came with did the job fine. But it's just a little more flat to help hold the bottom here. So, yeah, I like the accessories. So I guess I'll start with, I guess I'll use the entry grade RX-72 just because I love that model so much. I'll start with a comparison with that, because it is the general height of the RX-72, so it makes sense. And then I'll throw on a Zaku 2. I'll think of which one after, because I have so many. But then of course I'll compare with the original Zaku 1 color scheme, high grade, so you can see just how different this guy actually is compared to that one. Even though a lot of it is based on that model. It's amazing what a few little pieces can do. And that is the high-grade Zaku 1 sniper type. It's a good kit! I'm never going to expect to get a new version of it anytime soon, but this one is definitely serviceable. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.